Basilica Fadisho. Tunaona akiimbiwa na kina mama hapa wote wawili, na ili waweze kukaribishwa rasmi katika kanisa hili kama maaskofu. Na kwa hivyo kama unavyotazama ama kuona, kuna hivyo tutaendelea na shamra shamra hizi ambazo kwa sasa ni akina mama wanaimbia hawa maaskofu wetu wawili wateule. Na kwa sasa tunamuona Yohani Kardinali Jue ambaye alikuwa askofu wetu kitambo, ambaye anaongoza shamra shamra hizi. Baadaye wataweza kuweza kupumzika kidogo, ambapo watajiandaa kwa sala ya jioni na vile vile kuchukua oath of office na fidelity. Na kwa sasa tunawashagiria sana katika runinga yetu, na mnavyoona maaskofu wetu wateule Monsinyo Wallace na Monsinyo Simon Peter Kamomwe. Kuna watu wengi sana ambao wamejumuika, hasa kina mama wa CWA, wa Kristo wetu wa parokia Baribali, na vile vile kwaya ya Maina.
Time.
Your Excellency Bart van Meegen, the Apostolic Nuncio to Nyolo, David Kamau Nganga, the Auxiliary Bishop of Nairobi, Your Eminence John Cardinal Jue, Archbishop Emeritus of Nairobi, our brothers, the Bishop-elect, Monsignor Simon Peter Kamomoe, Monsignor Oris Nganga, Reverend Fathers present, religious men and women.
All the time.
Wow. Allow me to take this opportunity to welcome all of you to the Cathedral Parish of Holy Family Basilica. In fact, we are gathered here this evening to celebrate a moment of God's grace. And in celebrating a moment of God's grace is a moment whereby it is started in earnest in the morning at Gatondo, in the parish of the Martyrs of Uganda, with Holy Mass before proceeding on with grand procession, which took us to Kiambu. And here we are to our mother church, the Cathedral Parish and the Cathedral Church, which hold a lot for us as a diocese. And therefore, as we gather for Vespers, it's also a moment to thank God for his gratitude, for the blessings, above all, for our two brothers. Thank you for coming, for the prayers, for everything that you have done for them, and the joy that you have demonstrated this evening. So I welcome you, and in a special way, welcome.
Thank you very much. I want to make my remarks. My joy to see my brothers accepting to take the cross of Jesus. To be a bishop is to take a cross of Jesus, and I am sure they will do it. Your Excellency, the Nuncio, Your Eminent John Cardinal Jue, my brother Bishop David, and all of you who are here, it is a joy not for me alone, for the bishops alone, but for all of us, for what the wonderful things that God has done for us and the church, the universal church. It's an event of the whole entire church, and we want to thank God for this by participating with our minds, our spirit, and our energy. I want to recall that 100 years, when 1999, 100 years clicked, the Archdiocese of Nairobi was celebrating 100 years, 1999, ever since it was inaugurated or started by the Holy Spirit Fathers. And that time we got two bishops, two auxiliary bishops, in the name of Bishop David Kamau and Bishop Anthony Mukobo. And now it is going to 125 years, and yet now God has provided us again with the two other bishops again, in the name of Bishop Simon Kamomoi and also Wallace Nganga. What a blessing that we can count on. We clap hands. And with such coincidences, we have no reason to say God thank you, and assure God in our spirit and in our faith that we shall support the Church of Christ, the Church of God, to grow even in the deeper roots of its faith, and bear more fruits for all other people to come and enjoy the presence of God in our midst here. So I want to say thank you very much for coming. Let us follow up with the ceremony that begins today, and it continues into tomorrow. It's one major ceremony that will sanctify even all of us, and even your families and everybody at home. Present, I have the nuncio, I have Bishop David Kamau, and have His Eminence and the two here. I want to follow the procedure and the protocol as it will be indicated by yourself.
Tupigia askofu wetu mkuu makofi. Alivyoeleza Father Ndicho ni kwamba tulianza haya mambo asubuhi na ibada ya misa kule Gatundu, mashahidi wa Uganda, kwa hiyo parokia, kwa hiyo dekania ya Gatundu. Ibada ya misa ambayo iliongozwa na askofu David Kamau. Baada hapo tukua na msafara kuelekea Kiambu, ambapo masaa ilienda vile tulipaa kwa neema ya Mungu. Saa 9 kamili tukua na novena ya Divine Mercy. Saa 9 kamili walivyomba maaskofu wa teule. Baada hapo saa tukasema hapa kwa neema ya Mungu tufike saa 10:30, na kwa tumefika saa 10:30 kamili. Hii ni neema na baraka ya Mungu. Kwa wakati huu basi, we shall have the signing of the book, visitor's book, hapa baada ya maaskofu kusalimiana. Baada ya maaskofu kusalimiana, tutakuwa na signing of the visitor's book. Baada ya hapo kina mama wataenda, wataongoza the monsignors, watasindikiza the monsignors kule kwa nyumba. Wengine tutatangaziwa wakati waingia kanisa kwa kimya. We shall have vespers from 5:30 p.m. Huu ni wakati wa maombi, kuombea saa na shughuli za kesho, a time for prayer. So wakati wa kuingia kanisa tuingie tumenyamaza, tujue kwa hali ya maombi. Kwa mpangilio basi, basi kwa mkiendelea kwa wimbo, the two monsignors will sign this book during this historic day. Baada ya wimbo wa kwaya kumalizika wakisha sign kitabu, takuwa na wakati CWA Mwende na the two monsignors kuelekea kwa nyumba ya Father. Wengine tuwaomba tuingie kwa kanisa kwa kimya, tugoje na 1:30 wakati wa maombi jioni. Kwaya tuendelee kwa wimbo. Father Ndicho waongoze kwa kitabu cha wageni.
Utasaidia njia
tofagia njia
kiretea
maliza na hapo
wameweka sahi kitabu kwaya basi wakati huu wataelekea kwa nyumba wakipita hapa mbele ya kanisa kina mama washajipanga washajipanga upande hapa na maskofu request the bishops kind of us here CW here CW mta take over saa wengine tuingie kwa kanisa tujiandae kwa maombi ya jioni.
Imekuwa ni baada ya makaribisho hapa kwenye kanisa kuu la Holy Family Basilica kwa maaskofu wateule Wallace Nganga Gashihi na askofu mteule Simon Peter Kamomoe baada ya kutoka katika kanisa la watakatifu Petro na Paulo eneo la Kiambu mjini ambao ni kanisa ambayo iko kwenye kaunti ya pili katika zile mbili ambazo zina kaliwa na jimbo kuu katoliki la Nairobi. Basi baada ya zoezi hilo la mazungumzo mafupi na kutia sahihi kitabu cha wageni, wateule wanarudi kwa nyumba ya mapadre kupata tama la maji na baadaye mwendo wa saa 11 na nusu watarejea kwenye kanisa kwa sala ya jioni, sala ya kanisa. Kumbuka kwamba ni siku ya sita ya oktava ya Pasaka, kwa hivyo sala inaendelea ya jioni kama kwamba siku ni Jumapili. Maombi ya jioni yatafuata hivi karibuni. Tunashukuru wale wote ambao wamefanikisha matangazo hayo ya kukimbia kiasi, na tunashukuru Mungu kwamba ibada ya sala ya jioni inakaribia kuanza. Basi tunachukua kitambulisho kifupi na baadaye tutarejea kwa sala ya kanisa. Kiongozi wa sala hiyo bila shaka pamoja na wengine kama ulivyoshuhudia ni Askofu Mkuu Bart van Meegen, ambaye atasikiliza na kupokea kiapo cha hawa wawili kwa niaba na kwa ajili ya kanisa Baba Mtakatifu. Baada ya kitambulisho, sala ya jioni kutoka kanisa kuu la Holy Family Basilica.
Mpendo muumini, tumsifu Yesu Kristu. Baada ya Baba Mtakatifu Francisco kuwateua makuhani wawili kuwa maaskofu wasaidizi kwenye jimbo kuu la Nairobi, yanakaribia maadhimisho ya kuagwa, kupokelewa, kuwekwa wakfu na shukrani zao.
Ijumaa, tarehe 5 Aprili, itafanyika ibada ya misa ya kuaga Monsinyori Simon Peter Kamomoe na Monsinyori Wallace Nganga kutoka nyumbani kwao, dekania ya Mtakatifu Clara Gatundu.
Ibada hiyo itafanyika kwenye parokia ya Watakatifu Mashahidi wa Uganda mjini Gatundu, ikiongozwa na Askofu David Kamau kuanzia saa 4 asubuhi.
Baada ya misa, wateule hao wakisindikizwa na mapadre na waumini wataelekea kwenye kanisa la parokia ya Watakatifu Petro na Paulo mjini Kiambu.
Wanatarajiwa kufika hapo mwendo wa saa 8 mchana na kuwasalimia waumini.
Baadaye, mwendo wa saa 10 alasiri, wateule hao watawasili kwenye kanisa kuu la Holy Family Basilica mjini Nairobi, ambapo watapokelewa na mhashamu Askofu Mkuu Philip Anyolo, mapadre, watawa pamoja na waumini wengine.
Saa 11 jioni itafanyika ibada ya sala ya jioni kwenye kanisa lilo hilo, ambapo maaskofu wateule wataahidi uaminifu katika huduma ya waskofu pamoja na kukiri imani.
Ikue jioni, ikue asubuhi, siku ya kwanza.
Nayo siku ya pili, Jumamosi tarehe 6, itakuwa siku ya kihistoria ya kuwekwa wakfu maaskofu wateule Monsinyori Simon Peter Kamomoe na Monsinyori Wallace Nganga.
Ibada ya misa itafanyika kwenye uwanja wa shule ya St. Mary's eneo la Msongari kuanzia saa 4 asubuhi.
Msimikaji mkuu na kiongozi wa ibada atakuwa mwakilishi wa Baba Mtakatifu hapa nchini, mhashamu Bart van Meegen.
Kwaya itakayoongoza itatoka kwenye dekania ya Mtakatifu Clara Gatundu. Waumini wanaombwa kufika mapema na kuwa wameketi ifikapo saa 3 asubuhi.
Rangi ya liturujia itakuwa nyeupe ama dhahabu, na mapadri wote wanakumbushwa kuvaa kasula ama chasubo.
Baada ya ibada, maaskofu hao wawili watajiandaa kwa shukrani siku itakayofuata.
Ikue jioni, ikue asubuhi, siku ya pili.
Siku ya tatu, Jumapili ya pili ya Pasaka ama Jumapili ya huruma ya Mungu, Divine Mercy Sunday, itakuwa tarehe 7 Aprili. Siku hii itakuwa siku za shukrani za wahashamu hao wawili.
Mhashamu Simon Peter Kamomoe ataongoza ibada kwenye kanisa kuu la Holy Family Basilica Nairobi mjini, misa ya saa 2 asubuhi na saa 5 asubuhi.
Mhashamu Wallace Nganga naye atakuwa nyumbani pamoja na waumini wa parokia ya Yesu Kristu Mfalme eneo la Karinga.
Ibada ya misa itaanza saa 3:30 asubuhi. Ikue jioni, ikue asubuhi, siku ya tatu. Matukio na ibada za siku hizo tatu zitakujia kikamilifu na taadhima zote hapa tu Capuchin TV, maneno na matendo,
masomo na maombi,
mavazi na mapambo,
maelezo na maelekezo. Kwa kuwa Capuchin TV ndicho kituo cha kipekee kinachoweza kukuletea hayo bila kupunguza ama kuongeza chumvi.
Mungu abariki Jimbo Kuu Katoliki la Nairobi, pamoja na maaskofu wake, mapadri, watawa na waumini wote.
Endelea kutazama Capuchin TV.
Kitambulisho chako Katoliki. Priests are ordained equal. By then, some become bishops. Meet one of the bishops elect for the Catholic Archdiocese of Nairobi, Monsignor Wallace Nganga. Catholic born, Catholic raised and Catholic educated.
My name is Father Wallace Nganga. I come from, my home parish is Karinga Parish, and I have schooled there in the primary school. I schooled in a primary called Kiamwathi, then I moved to Gekure Primary. Then from there I went to Muhoho High School, and then from there I went to Muhoho High School. And Muhoho High School happened to be one of the Catholic schools, so the principal was a priest, the late Father Lafel Gwoko, who was a source of inspiration for us. And also we had a chaplain, Father Gashomba, Patrick Gashomba, who is currently working in Gathanga. And in fact, we got a lot of formation. Even I can say a lot of my background of spirituality is when I was in high school, because I was also the catechist for the students. I remember one time I was requested by Father Gashomba to write a letter to the servant of God, so that he could come and confirm 85 students from Muhoho High School, which I always recall with a lot of joy, that we had to invite him to come and also confirm the students. Some of them were being baptized, others got received for communion. We used to do service when the priest is not available. Those of us who are in the leadership of YCS, we are to read the service. So that we got a lot of encouragement with that. And Father Gashomba also introduced us to the divine office. We didn't know what it was. We used to go for morning prayers, and he would come with some papers with the prayers. Week one, we did not understand what it was. Only when we went to the seminary, we came to understand what this was about. And after Muhoho High School, then it is when now, as I was thinking of the next move after high school, that I found myself that joined the seminary. That is in 1996. I joined St. Mary's Moral Seminary.
From a student catechist of students to a priest and the Archdiocesan Pastoral Coordinator, he's now one of the two bishops elect for the Catholic Archdiocese of Nairobi.
I was ordained a priest in the year 2005. That time I was working as a deacon. I went first after appointment, after ordination, to serve at Mugedega Parish as a deacon. Then after 4 months, I was posted to Kiambu, where for coincidence, I worked under Father Simon Peter Kamomoe. Yes, and I was there as a deacon under him. And then when I was ordained, I was posted back to the same parish, St. Peter and Paul Kiambu. And within a duration of about a year or less than a year, then I was appointed to go by the list Archbishop Dinge Mwana Nzeki. He appointed me to go and start the new parish, St. Peter the Apostle Kikuyu. I found it as a big challenge, because when I went there, they had not finished the priest house. It was just a skeleton. And there was not even a tabernacle in that church. A lot of things that needed to be done. I felt it a big challenge for me, but I handled it, because, you know, Kikuyu is predominantly by PCA, Salaudin. You know, that is the headquarter of the PCA, Presbyterian Church. But we started well with the Christian there, and I'm happy. I stayed with them for about 3 years, from 2006 to 2009. Then when His Eminence came, he requested me to proceed for further studies at Catholic University. So I requested to be relieved on the father in charge, so that I can concentrate on the studies at Kwea. So I was supposed to be staying at Legina Cherry, that is in Karen as an assistant priest, but still being now a student at the Catholic University.
Back to school and back to books. To be prepared for yet again for another mission in the church, he then moved from the theory of classwork and back to the practical fieldwork in the parish.
For 2 years, I did my master's in pastoral theology while still working at Karen Parish. And in 2011, after my graduation, where we graduated in the month of October, I was appointed in November to become the pastoral coordinator. I still continued staying at Regina Cherry until 2015. And in 2015, I was appointed to become the father in charge of Christ the King, Ebakasi. There were some issues there, so His Eminence told me, go sort those issues when you are there. And going there, I thought I would go there for just a few months or 1 year or two, but I ended up serving there for 8 years, from 2015 to late last year, 2023. When I was now appointed to come and be the father in charge here at Ruaraka Parish. That has been my the history on how I have been working, yes.
But how has the ministry been serving God's people in different parishes and locations?
I can say that in each and every parish, I say I have a successful story I can give, starting with, of course, St. Peter and Paul, because St. Peter and Paul laid the foundation for me for my priesthood. You know, once you are ordained, the first appointment has a lot of impact and plays a very big role on your life. I can say under the guidance of Father Kamomoe, in fact, I got a chance even to put a strong background about my apostolate. That's what I can say. Father Kamomoe gave me a very strong backup and helps for me to stabilize now as a priest. Then going to St. Peter, the Apostle Kikuyu, you know, once you are appointed a father in charge and you are only 1 year in priesthood, it was a challenge, I can say that. But I have a story, a successful story, where I can say I managed even to make that parish stand. By the time I left within 3 years, and Father Kimiri is the one who came and took over from me, I was very happy because they were stable, they now knew what was expected. I had put structures in that parish and they were ready to go. In fact, the church where they are now, I'm the one who laid the foundation, where we put down one knee on the foundation of that church at that time. And right now, I'm happy, about 3-4 years ago, they opened that church and I'm very proud of that. And going to Karen also, it gave me an advantage. The church, you are a student and you are still doing your apostolate. That you'd go to school, but then in the evening, once you come back, you have a chance to go and visit the small Christian communities. And this also gave me a good, because I know in Karen, they were not very strong with the issue of jumuiyas. So when I got the aspect of now, what we are running class, I would come and share with my brother priest, that time we were with Father Kanyi, and the later Father Omondi. We tried the best to initiate small Christian communities, and even the crucial groups like CWACMA, I can say in Karen, we tried our best and we started them. That now CWA in Karen is very strong, CMA is very strong, smoked communities, they are very strong. That time I think they had only 3 or 4 smoked communities, and we shared and said, no, we have to create more jumuiyas, and that was very successful. But above all, the most successful story I can talk about is for Ebakasi. Why? Because Ebakasi, I was posted there because they had charities and they were having disunity, the issue of disunity among themselves. But my joy is the time I left there, I left a very united and joyful community. In fact, as I left, I felt happy. Have you ever been in a place whereby you feel, yes, God has helped me, that what I was supposed to do, I have done it? And I felt as I left there, I left a healed community, a very joyful and very vibrant church. And I can say that is something that makes me happy when I feel and I see that was achieved. Of course, here at Ruaraka, I have only stayed for 2 months. We had plans with them. We had sat down a number of times to discuss a number of issues on how best we would forge forward. But I believe also the priest will come and take over, will realize those dreams. But within two months, I can say I have achieved, because I must have touched one or two souls somewhere. Within those two months, I must have touched somebody.
Monsignor Wallace has served for long in the pastoral department of the Archdiocese of Nairobi. What does this office deal with in the day-to-day ministry of the church in Nairobi?
In the church, there are different departments, and I take care of the Archdiocese of Nairobi. We have different departments, but we have, of course, pastoral department, we have the procure department, vocation department, communication department, Caritas department, youth department, all these departments, they are there. But specifically when you talk about pastoral department, this is the heart of the church, because it deals with all matters that are spiritual, dealing with the faith of the Christians. All the issues that touch the faith of the Christians are held in this particular department. Me come to the issues of administration of sacraments, the pastoral department comes in to give guidance on how that should be done. Come to the issues of the devotional groups and the creation movements that we have in the church. How are they animated? How do they follow up with the charisms that they have? It is the role of the pastoral department to make sure that they follow it in the best way possible. Come to the issues even of formation of the leaders within the church whenever they are elected, and for them to know their role within the church. It is the role of the pastoral department to make sure that elections are done and procedures are followed, even the guidance to be followed within the church. When it comes to our pastoral councils, how do they conduct their meetings? Who qualifies? How do we conduct our prayers? Just give you an example. And until recently, even the pastoral department used to take care even of the religious men and women. Most of the issues pertaining the religious used to be brought to the desk of the pastoral coordinator. Thanks be to God, recently a new department was created that is making the work of the department easier. That is, now we have a vicar who is dealing with the religious. Also, we created now the issue of even the liturgy department, making the work easier. We also had, take care of the family life issues. They were all under the pastoral department. Right now, we have made the family life to be an independent department. And with all this, there is a lot, because even above all, is when it comes to the relationship between the clergy and the leaders within the parishes. That the issues that come when a priest has issues to do with the leaders within the council of the church, when there are those challenges, they come. When the priests want to form the leaders to make sure they follow the right guidelines and they pray their role as church leaders, they come to the pastoral office to get guidance. So it entails a lot. And at the same time, not forgetting, within the pastoral office, you act on behalf of the bishop. So the bishop is the pastor and is the one who takes and directs all the pastoral activities. So when you are there as a pastoral coordinator, I had to make sure that I brief the local ordinary. All the pastoral activities, what is happening, each and every parish, within the groups, the chaplains, how they are conducting the groups and animating these groups, then that was supposed to be done. And it is quite a lot within the church.
Serving in the parish as an administrator and doubling up as the Archdiocesan Pastoral Coordinator, we asked him, what drives you?
It has not been easy, but I must say that through the grace of God, I could manage. Because here you are running a parish. This is what is expected of you to fulfill as a father in charge, and especially matters of administration. Like now in Abakasi, you have the parish and we used to have a school. So with the school, you are the director of the school. And there are so many things that will be on your desk for you to address. Then in the pastoral office, there is what is awaiting you and you need to give guidance. And I must say, to be sincere, that God gave me the grace that I would be able to be, was able to balance. And what I would do, I wake up early. And most of the work I would do very early in the morning. If there is anything pending within the parish office, I'll be in the office early in the morning. But of course, the first thing is to get to the church and pray. You'll find me opening the church by 3:30, have my prayers. Then I go to the office. Then after clearing that, if I'm the one on duty there, then I go back to the church for mass. I start with the rosary. Maybe around 6 something, I'm back to the church. And we continue with the rosary, then we have mass. Then from there, I'll go back maybe to the parish office to clear other pending issues, or I proceed to the diocese. In case I was not on duty to celebrate Mass in the morning, I'll clear what is on the desk early in the morning, then proceed to the office, and I'll be in the office as early as 5. Then I'll clear what is there. I have appointments even as early as 5:30. I work in the office up to around 12:01. Then I'll come back to the parish. If there are jumuiyas and other things that need to be attended, then I'll attend later in the evening. Jumuiya is at 5, 6 or 7. If I don't have any jumuiya, then I'll sleep. Most of the times, I'll sleep very far. Me, by 8, I'll be asleep. But by 3, I'll be awake to even attend to other issues that needs my attention. But I, through the grace of God, that is what I'm saying, I have managed. And when it comes to take my off, then I'll take my break and relax, because it is healthy. Otherwise, you can break down. So it is always good that you take time when you also relax. Yes. Otherwise, the doctor will tell you to relax by force. Eh? Yes.
Yes. What is the role of an auxiliary or assisting bishop in the pastoral work of the local ordinary, and what does it entail?
I must say that, of course, it is an office that I will learn, because yet I have not been ordained for it and I am not yet practiced for it. But simply the work of the auxiliary bishop is to work and assist the local ordinary, who happens to be the archbishop of the archdiocese of Nairobi, Philip Arnold Anyoro. So our responsibility with the other auxiliary bishops, there is Bishop Kamau, Bishop now Father Kamomoe, will be supporting Archbishop Anyoro. And there is a lot of work, I can tell you, Father, within this diocese, because if you look like now at the diary of the Archbishop and Bishop Kamau, you find that many parishes are in need of the visit by the bishops, but sometimes they may not be available. I believe like now that we'll sit down and see how do we handle the issue of like confirmations, going for confirmations in the parishes. We have even the issue of like professions within the religious community, so many which are there. So the work of the archbishop will be easier. He'll sit down and he'll be guiding us on how to handle these particular issues. Of course, maybe even in issues, maybe administrative, there are issues that he would also tell us, we assist him, but of course it's under his own guidance, and his work a lot will be easier. That is what I can say.
The mentor the deacon and young priest, taking him to the altar for ordination and delegating the young priest as his curate. The mentor and the mentored are now the new auxiliary bishops in the Archdiocese of Nairobi. How does the Monsignor Wallace describe his mentor, fellow bishop elects?
I can say one thing is that Father Kamwe, by the way, has been my mentor. I don't know, what a coincidence. That I remember when I was being ordained, he's the one who drove me to the ordination in the morning. When I was being ordained in 2005, not knowing that I would be posted back to work with him. He drove me as a deacon as we went to here at Ruaraka, here at Mujua Furaha. This is where we ordained priests. A day where it was raining heavily, and I didn't know that after ordination I'll be posted back to the parish where I was working as a deacon. And I must say that within that time of 2 years, about 2 years that I worked with him, he taught me a lot about apostolate and also to treasure my priesthood. I must say that. That he could even give me responsibilities, because I remember that time he was also pursuing a course in psychology in the university. So most of the evening, I was the one left in charge to take care of the parish, because for him, he'll be out to the class. And then all the pastoral responsibilities in the evening, I was the one to take care of them. So he gave me a very strong foundation, and I must say he has a very strong personality, which I have admired all through. And he has supported me all through. And it was just a coincidence that both of us announced together to be auxiliary bishops. So I must say, he's a very inspiring priest, a man of God, somebody whom I have admired in my priesthood also.
Nairobi is the loudest political noisemaker in Kenya. But how does the man who deals with its Catholic pastoral activity describe it?
I have visited quite a number of parishes within these archdiocese. Mostly when it comes even to formation, and I have met so many leaders in parishes whenever we needed some formation. And even when there are particular issues and even celebrations within the diocese. And I must say one, that this is a diocese which is quite busy, pastorally busy. And I think in Kenya, it is one of the busiest. And then, as we speak now, I must say, currently the Archdiocese of Nairobi is one of the dioceses we have very good structures. Thanks to our retired Archbishop Emeritus, Cardinal Njue, he put structures that you can say today as we stand here. Every leader within this Archdiocese knows what is expected of him. The priest know what to do pastorally. So I must say that the Archdiocese of Nairobi is at another level when it comes to pastoral work. And at the same time, it is growing. There is a very high potentiality of our diocese growing. If you go out and in the outskirts as Nairobi is moving out, there are so many areas we need to open churches, we need to open our stations, we need to open even parishes. So many, there is a high demand. And no wonder, according to the statistics, it was labeled that in Kenya, this is where we have seen the highest number, one of the highest number of Christians attending the churches, the Catholics. No wonder that came, because Nairobi, we can say we have quite a high number. And I would say it has a lot of hope, and with the guidance and with God's will, it will go to greater heights. That is what I can say. That is a very potential diocese when it comes to pastoral activities. And it shines there as a zeal to even other dioceses.
Gatundu does not just produce political leaders. It has been a consistent seedbed and conveyor belt of Catholic priests for the Archdiocese of Nairobi from time immemorial. How does the bishop-elect describe his roots?
I must say that Karinga Parish happens to be from Gatundu Deanery, and the larger Gatundu, we talk of Gatundu South and Gatundu North, and it is something unique within that deanery and that area because of the spirituality of the Holy Ghost Fathers. And they left very strong roots of Catholicism that today, if you go those sides, if you talk about the Catholic faith, you hear them talk about Father McGill, but the, you know, for the Kikuyus, they will not talk about McGill, they will talk about Magiri, because they want to collapse to the name. But the spirituality that was led by the Holy Ghost Fathers has inspired that to the extent that we have so many vocations within the Gatundu, larger Gatundu, even Gatundu South. And from Karinga, I must say that we were brought up going to the church, thanks to my parents who are very devoted to the Catholic Church, that would go even to church and would be brought up and also be trained and be formed as per the Catholic teaching, and also the formation that were given in schools. And that has played a very big role. And I can say, even according to my background, as I said earlier, my biggest inspiration came when I was in Moho High School. I had my own challenges as I grew up. I come from a very humble background. So even I had challenges when going to school, even the issue of school fees, nobody to pay for my school fees. People supported me, especially my teachers in primary school. And even the understanding of teachers in high school, they made me succeed and finish school. Were it not for them, maybe I don't know whether I would have finished school. And it is out of that, and especially the love that Father Woko portrayed to me when I reported there. When I was in school, I happened to have been the best student, and when I was admitted there, I could not afford to report. And he said, "You come report with whatever you have," and this inspired me. And no wonder this is where now my vocation to priesthood came from. That if a priest, a principal, can say, "You come," and then you'll be sorting other things. That touched me and made me even go stronger in faith. So I can say the Christians of Karinga Parish are very happy and very proud. And I am very happy and proud of them. They gave me the background. They have nurtured me. They have seen me grow. They know me very well. You know, they call me Wakefodhu. Wakefodhu, I am named after my grandfather. They will not even call me father. They will call me Wakefodhu because that is what, as I grew up in the village, that is how they will call me. But I can say I'm very proud of them because they have supported me and they are my source of backbone to who I am.
Monsignor Wallace has a word to priests.
My message to my fellow priest, my brother priest, and especially I start with my classmates who we journeyed together from the time we joined the seminary in 1996. I must first thank them for the support they have given me. We journeyed together as colleagues. We have always been together, and I promise them that I'll pray for them, I'll support with them. We continue being classmates despite the now that level of episcopate, but we continue journeying together, I'll support them. I'll call upon them and also my brother priests, wherever they are, that we continue being proud of our priesthood. We continue being proud of our priesthood, and let us find joy by serving. There is no greater joy that a priest can get than when you go out, you serve the Christians and come back, even if you feel tired, even if you are sleeping as you sit there watching news because you are tired. That is the biggest joy that you find as a priest. May we find that joy by serving the Christians, because that is the call that God has called us. And there is nowhere else we may get our joy. It is just going out to the small communities, serving the needy, serving those who are sick. And as we come back, serving somebody and listening to somebody who has an issue in the office, because listening, you know, it is very challenging sometimes to listen. Somebody giving a story for about 2 hours and you have to listen. And maybe at the end of the day, you don't have a solution. And you have to tell the person that I'll pray for you. That listening also heals. And we need that zeal and that patience as we serve the people of God. I wish them God's blessings, and I promise them that I'll pray for them. For those who are together within the Archdiocese of Nairobi, I'll support you and I will journey with you.
Na ujumbe wake kwa waumini wa Katoliki katika changamoto wanazopitia.
Wakristo wote, ningetaka kusema kwamba katika safari hii, sisi wote tumeitwa tumtumikia Mwenyezi Mungu. Na ni ukweli kwamba katika dunia hii, tunayo changamoto mingi. Na kama vile masomo ya Jumapili ya leo imetuelekeza, sisi wote tumeitwa tuelekee jangwani. Na katika hii jangwani tutapitia majaribu mengi kama vile hata Yesu aliweza kujaribiwa. Na lakini katika haya majaribu tumesikia kwamba Yesu alitoka akiwa mshindi. Hakupea shetani nafasi yoyote kumwangusha katika imani yake. Mimi yangu ni kuambia Wakristo wote kwamba tumtegemee Mwenyezi Mungu. Na tusimame imara katika imani yetu. Tuombee nchi yetu. Hata kama kuna changamoto zenye ziko, pia tuangalie na tuone mazuri ambayo yako. Kwa sababu katika dunia nchi hii yetu, hata kama kuna changamoto, there are so many good things. Kuna mengi mazuri. Kwanza tufurahie yale mazuri na baraka ambazo tumepata kutoka kwa Mwenyezi Mungu. Lakini pia sisi ambao tuko katika kanisa, tuwe mfano bora hata kwa wale wengine. And especially the elderly, we be a good example to the young ones. There are young ones who have challenges and they need our inspiration. They need our support. May we never get tired. Tuwashikirie mkono na mjue kwamba sisi kama maskofu wateule tutawaombea na tutashirikiana katika safari hii ya imani. Na naomba pia mtuombe, kwa sababu hili jukumu tumepewa sio jukumu rahisi. Inahitaji neema ya Mwenyezi Mungu, na najua kwamba nyinyi mkituombea na Roho Mtakatifu atuongoze, yote tutaweza kwa uwezo wa Mwenyezi Mungu.
Hatimaye siku aliyoifanya Bwana inakaribia.
Kwa siku yetu na waalika muweze kuja kushuhudia our Episcopal ordination on 6th of April. This is a special invitation. Of course, I know Archbishop will send the official invitation. Lakini tunawaalika nyote muje mshuhudie. Lakini zaidi na waomba wakati huu na wakati wowote, tafadhali mutuweke as a prayer item in your prayers. Musitusahau. Tafadhali mukiomba, mutuweze kutukumbuka katika sala. Mungu awabariki, awaongoze na warinde kwa yote. Asante.
Capuchin TV, tunawapongeza na kuombea baraka na neema maaskofu wateule Monsignor Simon Peter Kamomoe na Monsignor Wallace Nganga. Mungu awabariki na kuongoza katika kazi aliyowaitia.
Ni kwenye vitongoji duni vya kwetu
ambapo pana ukombozi. Nani mkombozi? Nani anayekombolewa? Na ni ukombozi upi? Kitongoji cha kwetu ni mojawapo wa vitongoji vya Mombasa. Kitovu chake ni Padre Michael. Padre Mkatoliki ambaye amejizatiti na kung'oa nanga safari mahususi ya kukabiliana na dawa za kulevya, uhalifu na uozo wa tabia kwenye jamii yake.
Siwezi kuendelea hivyo. Nimechoka na maisha tunayoishi na nahitaji kujitoa. Siwezi endelea kufanya hivyo.
Hauwezi tu kujitoa. Kumbuka tuliapa. Maisha haya ndio tunayo.
Kwenye parokia yake mpya ya kwetu.
Mimi ndio Padre mgeni hapa.
Padre Michael. Padre mgeni.
Padre Michael ana nia kuu ya kuinua vijana wanaohangaika na kuwapa tumaini kwenye maisha yao.
Tuko na kazi kubwa usiku wa leo. Ushindi mkubwa humo ndani.
Kwenye kukabiliana na changamoto chungu nzima za vitongojini, Padre Michael anakutana ana kwa ana na vijana wengi ambao wamenaswa na mtego wa utumiaji wa dawa za kulevya na uhalifu. Vijana hao ambao hapo mbeleni walikuwa vielelezo na haswa kanisani, kwa sasa wamejipata kwenye dimbwi la ukiwa na mahangaiko na kukata tamaa.
Hivi lakini wewe unahusika na nini?
Nisikie kwa makini Sara. Sina wakati wa kuhusishwa na madai yasiyokuwa ya msingi.
Kwenye simulizi la ukombozi, tunangamua wazi mahangaiko na simulizi ya vijana hawa. Kuanzia kwa Sara, mwana harakati ambaye amejitolea kuwasaidia wanarika wenzake, hadi kwa Kelvin, mhalifu aliyebadilisha mwendo na anayetafuta ukombozi. Simulizi hii inapigia mbizi hisia za safari ndefu ya mabadiliko na kufanywa upya. Hata kukiwa na pingamizi ndani na nje ya vitongoji hivi, Padre Michael anaendelea na nia yake isiyotingika, ikipigwa jeki pakubwa na kanisa na wanaojitolea. Kwa pamoja, wanasimama kama mwanga wa tumaini, wakiwa na nia kupanda mbegu ya mabadiliko na ukombozi.
Padre Michael, tuna matumaini makuu ya kukuza jamii iliyo njema. Lakini pamoja na hayo, hatuwezi kusahau changamoto tunazopitia kama kanisa.
Safari kamwe sio rahisi rafiki yangu. Tutang'ang'ana hivyo. Hapa katikati ya mapambano ndipo ninapoanza.
Ungana nasi hapa Capuchin TV kila Jumamosi saa 1 jioni na Jumapili saa 9:30. Ukombozi.
Karibu tena mpendwa mtazamaji wa Capuchin TV popote pale ulipo, ikiwa ni siku ya Ijumaa tarehe ya 5 ya mwezi huu wa 4, ambapo kanisa kwenye jimbo hili kuu Katoliki la Nairobi linaadhimisha matukio makuu katika historia ya jimbo hili kuu kwamba tangu miaka 24 iliyopita walipotawazwa maaskofu wawili wasaidizi kwenye jimbo hili kuu, ni wakati mwingine ambapo jimbo hilo linapata wachungaji wengine wawili. Hii ni baada ya Baba Mtakatifu kuwatangaza mapadre Simon Peter Kamomoe na padre Wallace Nganga Gashehi kuwa maaskofu wasaidizi wateule mpaka sasa, ambapo kesho ndio siku ya kuwaweka wakfu. Imekuwa ni siku ya Ijumaa ambapo imekuwa na shughuli za kiliturujia kutoka asubuhi kule kwenye dekania yao ya nyumbani ya Mtakatifu Clara. Wamekuwa katika kanisa la Watakatifu Mashahidi wa Uganda Gatundu mjini kwa ibada ya misa ya kuagwa rasmi kule mashinani, ibada iliongozwa na askofu David Kamau Nganga, askofu msaidizi kwenye jimbo hili. Na baadaye wakaelekea katika kanisa kuu ambalo liko kwenye kaunti ya Kiambu, ambalo ni kanisa la Watakatifu Petro na Paulo Mitume. Kumbuka kwamba jimbo kuu Katoliki la Nairobi limekalia kaunti hizo mbili, kaunti ya Kiambu na kaunti ya Nairobi. Na hapo wakawa na mapokezi na sala ya huruma ya Mungu, sala ya saa 9 alasili, na baadaye wakasindikizwa na wamepokelewa kwenye malango ya kanisa hili kuu, Holy Family Basilica, na askofu mchungaji mkuu kwenye jimbo hili, Mhashamu Philip Arnold Subira Anyolo, pamoja na askofu mkuu mstaafu Mwadhama John Kardinali Njue, pamoja na mwakilishi wa Baba Mtakatifu hapa nchini na Sudan Kusini, Bart Van Meegen. Kama ilivyo ratibiwa, ibada ya jioni hii ni sala ya jioni, sala ya kanisa. Na kama kwa wale pengine hawafahamu, sala ya jioni ya kanisa zaidi inasaliwa na mapadre na watawa wa kiume na wa kike, lakini muumini yote yule anaweza kusali sala hiyo au pamoja na wao ama peke yake, na akifuata vitabu ambavyo ni vya sala kama ilivyo ratibiwa. Sala ya asubuhi, sala ya jioni, sala ya mchana na sala ya usiku ni muda wa masaa ambao wa mapadre na watawa wanasali. Ikiwa sala ya jioni kwa mfano inakuwa na sehemu ama zaburi mbili na wimbo. Zaburi ya kwanza katika sala ya jioni ya leo imetolewa katika Zaburi 110, na ni sifa, wimbo wa sifa, ambapo tukiwa katika kipindi cha Pasaka na hasa katika oktava ya Pasaka, kila siku katika oktava ni kama Jumapili, kwa hivyo ni zaburi na wimbo ulioimbwa Jumapili ya ufufuko wa Bwana. Zaburi ya kwanza ni Zaburi 110. Mungu alimwambia Bwana wangu, keti mkono wangu wa kuume mpaka nitakapowafanya maadui zako kama kiti cha kuwekea miguu yangu. Zaburi ya pili ni Zaburi ya 114, ambayo pia ni wimbo ambao ama ni zaburi inayosema jinsi Mungu alivyowaokoa Waisraeli kutoka nchi ya Misri, tukikumbuka kwamba katika usiku wa Pasaka somo moja wapo ya yale masomo ambayo ni ya lazima ni kitabu cha Kutoka sura ya 14, ambapo ni kuvushwa bahari ya Shamu wana wa Israeli. Zaburi ya pili jioni ya leo ni Zaburi 114, ambayo inaongea kuhusu Waisraeli walipovuka kutoka Misri. Wimbo ambao unatolewa katika Agano la Kale ama Agano Jipya wakati huu wa kipindi hiki cha Pasaka oktava, wimbo unatoka katika Ufunuo wa Yohane sura ya 19, ambayo inasema Aleluya, mshukuruni Bwana na aliyewakomboa watu wake. Kama tunavyosema, ni kipindi cha Pasaka, wimbo wa kumtukuza Mungu. Somo ambalo linasomwa katika sala ya jioni baada ya zaburi na wimbo, somo la leo limetoka katika Injili kama ilivyoandikwa na Yohane Mtakatifu sura ya 20, pale ambapo ni baada ya ufufuko, Maria Magdalena akirauka kwenda kaburini na ushuhuda wake. Na pia katika ibada ya leo, baada ya sala hiyo, wale wateule wawili, kila mmoja wakati wake, wataakiri imani. Maana yake atajitaja yeye mwenyewe, na anakiri, anaungama imani hadharani kama kielelezo cha kwamba atabaki mwaminifu katika imani Katoliki na la mitume. Na baadaye atakula kiapo cha ofisi na uaminifu kwa askofu mkuu, ambaye ni mchungaji mkuu wa kundi la Mungu, Baba Mtakatifu mwenyewe, Francisco, na waandamizi wake bila shaka, ambapo ataapa kwamba ataendelea kulinda imani, ataendelea kufundisha imani, kulinda mali ya kanisa na kuweza kutafuta miito kwa ajili ya kanisa la Mwenyezi Mungu. Hayo ni maneno ambayo tutayasikiliza katika kiapo tukijiandaa katika siku ya kesho ambayo ni siku ya kuwekwa wakfu kwao. Watakaoongoza sala hiyo ni hawa wa seminari ambao wametoka katika waonyeshe picha hii ya hawa wa seminari ambao ni wa seminari ambao wametoka katika vyuo vya hapa jimbo kuu la Nairobi, chuo cha wanafunzi ama wa seminari ambao wanasoma masomo ya kuwa mapadre. Hawa wametoka katika chuo cha Mtakatifu Toma wa Aquino na wengine wametoka katika chuo cha Mtakatifu ama Mwenyeheri Isidro Bakanja. Hao ndio watakuwa wakituongoza pamoja na waumini, pamoja na masista na wapadre na waumini wale wengine. Basi jiunge nasi kwa sala hii kuu ya kanisa tunapokuwa katika siku ya kwanza ya siku tatu muhimu katika maisha ya hawa wateule kwa ajili ya ibada itakayokuwa hiyo kesho. Basi kutoka kanisa kuu la Holy Family Basilica ni sala ya jioni itakayoongozwa na mwakilishi wa Baba Mtakatifu hapa nchini, Bath Van Meegen, mapadre na watawa pamoja na watu wa Mungu. Tumtolee Mwenyezi Mungu shukrani zetu na maombi yetu, mahitaji ya familia zetu na mahitaji ya wengi waliotuomba, tuwakumbuke kwenye sala. Jiunge nasi kwa sala hii.
O God, come to my assistance. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Na Yesu kafufuka tumwimbie kwa furaha. Haleluya, 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 haleluya. Kweli Yesu kafufuka.
to see the Lord's tomb. Alleluia.
Lord, sit at my right.
wanted my brothers to set out for Galilee. There they will see me. Alleluia.
Spell. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb early, while it was still dark, and saw that the stone had been taken away from the tomb. She ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." Peter then came out with the other disciple, and they went toward the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first, and stooping to look in, he saw the linen clothes lying there, but he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came following him and went in the tomb. He saw the linen clothes lying and the napkin which had been on the head, not lying with the linen clothes, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple, who reached the tomb first, also went in, and he saw and believed. For as yet they did not know the scripture, that he must rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
The last one that we sang from the book of Revelation. The wedding feast of the Lamb has begun, and his bride is prepared to welcome him. Alleluia. If now, this evening, you would go to St. Austin's, then you would find everything ready already. The wedding feast for the Lamb is about to begin. And the bride is prepared, that is, the church is prepared, and also we tonight here already, we are prepared. Prepared to receive the bridegroom, to prepare to receive Christ, but in a special way, Christ in these two men, these two priests, these two bishops elect, who tomorrow are going to be ordained, going to be, yes, you may say, wedded to the church in a special way. And that's also why they will receive a ring, so as to show that actually they have been given away to the church, to be wedded to the church. The wedding feast of the Lamb has begun, and the bride is prepared to welcome him. That is where we are tonight. And there's already like this energy in the air. And of course, you feel it. There is the expectation and the joy for what is going to happen tomorrow. And just before we, the bishops here and some of our priests, came to the church, we got our last instructions from the master of ceremonies and from the chief of protocol, so to say, on how to behave tomorrow. Because, well, the president is coming and you need to be at your best. Everything is prepared for tomorrow. But at the same time, there's the gospel that we read just now. The gospel of Peter and the one disciple that Jesus loved in a special way, which is always identified, who's always identified with John, Peter, and John, the old man, the young man, running to the tomb. Peter, who stands, of course, for the Pope, stands for the institutional church, stands for legality, for jurisdiction, for tradition. And at the same time, there is John. John is the one who looks with the heart, who listens with the heart, so to say, the contemplative. And both of them, they come together, maybe even like in these two here. It comes together. But they have to go into the tomb. Simon Peter came following him and went into the tomb, and he saw the linen cloth lying and the napkin. And then also the other disciple who reached the tomb first also went in, and he saw and believed. For as yet they did not know the scriptures that he must rise from the dead. In a sense, yes, everything is prepared and we are ready for the wedding feast of the Lamb. But at the same time, these two, and of course we do not leave them alone, we, all of them, all of us, we go with them into the tomb tonight. And I've mentioned it before in another homily, in another preparation for the ordination of a bishop. I still remember how it happened to me years ago, that my friend, who had been ordained just 2-3 years before me, he said to me, "Well, Bert, you will see that last night will be a valley of tears for you. You will not sleep that night." And I thought, Julio, I'm Dutch, we are cool, we don't do that. But exactly the opposite happened, I have to say. That night before my Episcopal ordination, I could not sleep. It seems I had a fever. I walked through my bedroom. I thought I had malaria. I was afraid I had to cancel. Till finally, at about 4 o'clock in the morning, I could fall asleep and slept soundly and profoundly for another 4 hours, till I nearly overslept the breakfast with the Cardinal Secretary of State, who was at that time in my diocese. In a sense, it seems that we all have to go through that tomb experience each and every time again. You have to go into the dark. So as to understand better what Jesus is expecting from you. And so also to understand better what this resurrection is really about. Because if you do not know what death is, then how do you ever going to understand what resurrection is? There is no resurrection without death. There is no eternal life. No wedding feast of the Lamb without a tomb. So today, this evening, we pray in a special way for Simon Peter and for Wallace as they are entering into the tomb, as they will go through this last night as priests in order to be wedded tomorrow to the bride. The bride who is prepared to welcome them. And tonight, there's in a sense a last test. They need to do their profession of faith, their oath of fidelity. Oath of fidelity, of course, to the Holy Father, Peter, but in a way also to the Church itself. and we want to be with them here this evening. Just very grateful that so many of you have come to accompany these two men on this great and special evening as they are preparing to be ordained. Dear Monsignor Simon Peter, Monsignor Wallace, we remain with you. We accompany you with our prayers so that tomorrow you will have a splendid wedding feast. Amen.
We take a brief moment in silence, reflect on the exposure of the good news as shared with us by His Excellency the Nuncio.
We shall have profession of faith and oath of fidelity by the two Monsignors. Kindly let us all arise. The first one will be Monsignor Simon Peter Kavumoe, who proceed to go and then kneel before the altar for profession of faith.
I, Monsignor Simon Peter Kavumoe, with firm faith, believe and profess each and everything that is contained in the symbol of faith, namely, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven and became man. For our sake he was crucified at the Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on that day in accordance to the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With the firm faith, I also believe everything contained in the Word of God, whether written or handed down in tradition, and which the Church, either by a solemn judgment or by the ordinary ad universal magisterium, sets forth to be believed as divine revealed. I also firmly accept and hold each and everything definitively proposed by the Church regarding teaching on faith and morals. Moreover, I adhere with religious submission of will and intellect to the teachings which either the Roman Pontiff or the College of Bishops enunciates when they exercise their authentic magisterium, even if they do not intend to proclaim these teachings by a definitive act.
At this point, Monsignor Simon Peter Kamamoyo took the oath of fidelity, placing his hands on the books or the book of the Gospels.
I, Monsignor Simon Peter Kamamoyo, having been appointed as the Auxiliary Bishop of Nairobi, will always be faithful to the Catholic Church and the Roman Pontiff, our Supreme Pastor, the Vicar of Christ, the successor of the Blessed Apostle Peter in the primacy and the head of the College of Bishops. I will respect the free exercise of the primacy of the Supreme Pontiff over the Universal Church, and I will take care to promote and defend his rights and authority. I will also acknowledge and respect the prerogatives and duties of the legates of the Roman Pontiff who act in the person of the Supreme Pastor. With the utmost diligence, I will carry out the apostolic duties entrusted to bishops, namely to teach, sanctify, and rule the people of God in hierarchical communion with the head and members of the College of Bishops. I will watch over the unity of the Universal Church and thus will make every effort to ensure that the deposit of faith handed down from the apostles is preserved pure and entire, and that the truths to be held and put into practice will be passed on and clearly explained to all as they are proposed by the Church's magisterium. I will show paternal affection to those who err in faith, and I will make every effort to guide them to the fullness of Catholic truth. Having before me the image of Christ, the supreme and eternal priest, I will conduct myself conscientiously and reverently, and thus fulfill the ministry entrusted to me, so that having become myself an example to the flock, I'll be able to confirm the faith in the pursuit of Christian perfection. I will uphold the discipline common to the whole church, and will carefully promote the observance of all ecclesiastical laws, particularly those contained in the Code of Canon Law. I will be ever vigilant to prevent possible abuses, especially with regard to the ministry of the Word and the celebration of the sacraments. I will diligently look after the administration of the Church's temporal goods, especially those destined for divine worship, for the proper sustenance of the clergy and other ministers, and for the works of the apostolate and of charity. In carrying out the mandate entrusted to me, I will show particular affection to all the priests and deacons, the prudent proprietors of the order of bishops, and to men and women religious sharers in one work. I will likewise take great care to promote sacred vocations so that the spiritual needs of the whole church will be appropriately met. I will recognize and promote the dignity of lay people and their proper role in the church's mission. I'll be especially concerned to promote missionary works aimed are the evangelization of peoples. Unless he pleaded, I will personally attend or prompt response when called to councils and other legitimate collegial actions. At determined times, all as the occasion demands, I'll give an account of my pastoral office to the Apostolic See, and to the best of my ability, I will respectfully accept and carry out its mandate and counsels. So help me, God, and this holy gospel, which I touch with my heart.
We may be seated for a short moment as Monsignor Simon Peter Kamomoe will sign, but the witness, as we have it, the Apostolic Nuncio, will also testify that Monsignor Simon Peter Kamomoe professed the faith and sworn the oath in his presence. Monsignor Simon Peter Kamomoe is signing, then His Excellency the Apostolic Nuncio will sign as the witness.
Hicho cha askofu mteule anaweka sahihi kitabu cha kumbukumbu kama kumbukumbu yake mwenyewe na ushahidi wa kwamba aliapa hayo, kama tunavyofanya ama kama inavyofanyika katika kiapo chochote. Kama kiapo cha sakramenti ya ndoa, kuna kutia sahihi. Sasa kiapo cha sakramenti ya daraja takatifu ya uaskofu ni pia kuweka sahihi, na anaweka sahihi nakala kadhaa ambazo zitawekwa katika ofisi tofauti kulingana na mafundisho ya kanisa, akisaidiwa pale na mhudumu wa mipango ya kiliturujia kwenye jimbo kuu Katoliki la Nairobi, na shahidi akiwa askofu mkuu Bart Van Meegen, msimamizi wa Baba Mtakatifu hapa nchini. Ni kiapo ambacho kina uzito wa maneno kama tulivyosikia, na tuendelea kutafakari kiapo hicho anaapa nini askofu mteule. Kwanza, amekiri imani moja takatifu Katoliki la mitume, na akaapa kuwajibika kwa mchungaji mkuu wa kundi la Mungu, mwandamizi wa mtume Petro, Baba Mtakatifu na baraza la maaskofu na makardinali. Ameapa kwamba ataendelea kulinda mali ya kanisa, na hasa wajibikaji katika kutoa sakramenti za kanisa. Amesema kwamba katika maneno hayo, nitaangalia kanisa katika umoja, I will watch over the unity of the universal church. Maana yake anaahidi kulinda umoja wa kanisa, akiendelea pia kusema katika huduma zake ataendelea kuonyesha upendo kwa mapadre, mashemasi na wahudumu wa kweli wa uaskofu, waume kwa wake, watawa pamoja na wale wanaohudumu katika kanisa. Nitahuisha miito katika kazi ya kanisa, na nitalinda umoja wa walei katika kazi na huduma za kanisa. Amesema unless impeded, kama sio kutoweza, nitawajibika mwenyewe katika baraza za maaskofu na huduma zinazolingana na wito huo. Na akasema, e Mungu nisaidie.
To kneel before the holy altar, to profess the faith and take the oath of fidelity.
Wallace Nganga Gashihi nae kwanza ataapa ama atakiri imani hadharani mbele ya msalaba, mbele ya altari. Tusikie maneno yake.
I, Monsignor Wallace Nganga, with firm faith believe and profess each and everything that is contained in the symbol of faith, namely, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before ages, God from God, right from right, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven and became man. For our sake he was crucified at Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With firm faith, I also believe in everything contained in the Word of God, whether written or handed down in the tradition, and which the Church, either by a solemn judgment or by the ordinary and universal magisterium, sets forth to be believed as divine revealed. I also firmly accept and hold each and everything differently proposed by the Church regarding the teaching of faith and morals. Moreover, I adhere with the rigid submission of will and intellect the teachings which either the Roman Pontiff or the College of Bishops enunciate when they exercise their authentic magisterium, even if they do not intend to proclaim these teachings by a definitive act.
Now, in his turn, Monsignor Wallace will raise his hand on the book of the Gospels and take the oath of fidelity.
I, Monsignor Wallace Nganga, having been appointed as an auxiliary bishop of Nairobi, will always be faithful to the Catholic Church and the Roman Pontiff, her supreme pastor, the Vicar of Christ, the successor of the blessed Apostle Peter, in the primacy and the head of the College of Bishops. I will respect the free exercise of the primacy of the Supreme Pontiff over the Universal Church, and I will take care to promote and defend his rights and authority. I will also acknowledge and respect the prerogatives and duties of the legates of the Roman Pontiff who act in the person of the Supreme Pastor. With the utmost diligence, I will carry out the apostolic duties entrusted to bishops, namely to teach, sanctify, and rule the people of God in hierarchical communion with the head and members of the College of Bishops. I will watch over the unity of the Universal Church and thus to make every effort to ensure that the deposit of faith handed down from the apostles is preserved pure and entirely, and that the truths to be held and put into practice will be passed on and clearly explained to all as they are proposed by the church magisterium. I will show paternal affection to those who are in faith, and I will make every effort to guide them to the fullness of Catholic truth. Having before me the image of Christ, the supreme and eternal priest, I will conduct myself consciously and reverently, and thus fulfill the ministry entrusted to me, so that, having become myself an example to the flock, I'll be able to confirm the faithful in the pursuit of Christian perfection. I will uphold the discipline common to the whole church, and will carefully promote the observance of all ecclesiastical rules, particularly those contained in the Code of Canon Law. I'll be ever vigilant to prevent possible abuses, especially with regard to the ministry of the Word and the celebration of the sacrament. I will diligently look after the administration of church temporal goods, especially those destined for divine worship, for the proper sustenance of the clergy and other ministers, and for the works of the apostolate and of charity. In carrying out the mandate entrusted to me, I will show particular affection to all priests and deacons, the prudent cooperators of the order of bishops, and to men and women regis, sharers in one work. I will likewise take great care to promote sacred vocations, so that the spiritual needs of the whole church will be appropriately met. I will recognize and promote the dignity of the lay people and their proper role in church mission. And I will be especially concerned to promote missionary works aimed at the evangelization of the peoples. Unless impeded, I will personally attend or promptly respond when called to councils and other legitimate collegial actions. At determined times, or as the occasion demands, I will give an account of my pastoral office to the Apostolic See, and to the best of my ability, I will respectfully accept and carry out its mandates and counsels. So help me God and these holy gospels which I touch with my hand.
Briefly, we may be seated. Once again, we'll have Monsignor Willis signing the documents on the profession of faith and oath of fidelity. Along with him, in testament, that he has professed the faith, the nuncio will also be signing. We continue imploring the mercy of God and His graces upon His servants, the two Monsignors, as we prepare to take the office of the bishop, successors of the apostles, they may truly be shepherds of the people as the Lord has so desired.
Wapili kuapa na kuahidi uaminifu katika ofisi ya askofu ni mhashamu Wallace Ng'ang'a. Kumbuka kwamba ni siku ya kwanza katika siku tatu maalum za hawa wateule. Siku ya leo, Ijumaa tarehe 5, itabaki katika kumbukumbu za maisha yao, siku ambayo waliapa na wakatia sahihi nakala za vyeti vya huduma walioipokea kwenye altari, juu ya altari katika kanisa la Holy Family Maina Basilica mwaka 2024, miezi takriban mitatu baada ya wao kuteuliwa na Baba Mtakatifu Francisco kuwa maaskofu wasaidizi wake, Askofu Mkuu Philip Arnold Subira Anyolo. Na jimbo kuu la Nairobi litakuwa la pili kwenye bara la Afrika kuwa na maaskofu wasaidizi watatu, likijiunga na jimbo Katoliki kuu la Kinshasa kwenye nchi ya kidemokrasia ya Kongo, ambayo jimbo hilo pia liko na Askofu Mkuu Fridolin Abongo Mwadhama Kardinale na maaskofu watatu wasaidizi. Mwakilishi wa Baba Mtakatifu anaweka sahihi pia kwa niaba ya Baba Mtakatifu na kwa niaba ya kanisa vyeti vya hao wawili, na anaandika kwa mkono wa kushoto. Bila shaka hapo awali mwandishi wa mkono wa kushoto alikuwa anaonekana kama si kamili, lakini ni maumbile. Kwa hivyo anaweka sahihi kwenye nakala hizo ambazo zitahifadhiwa kwenye makavazi ya kanisa hapa kwenye jimbo kuu la Nairobi, na nakala bila shaka itabaki katika ofisi yake mwakilishi wa Baba Mtakatifu hapa nchini, na nakala nyingine itaenda Vatican mjini Roma kwenye ofisi za Baba Mtakatifu. Ni maneno yaliyo na uzito kama tuliyoyasikia, wateule wawili wakiapa uaminifu na kazi ambazo zinalingana na ofisi yao. Kumbuka kwamba daraja takatifu ama sakramenti ya daraja takatifu ina ngazi tatu. Ya kwanza ngazi ya ushemasi, ambapo mteule anawekewa tu mikono na askofu. Daraja ya pili, daraja ya upadre, mteule ambaye ni shemasi anapakwa mafuta kwenye mikono na anawekewa mikono na mapadre wote ambao wamehudhuria. Na daraja ya tatu hii ya uaskofu tutaona hivyo kesho, kwamba atapakwa mafuta ya krisma kwenye kichwa chake, atawekewa mikono na maaskofu watakaokuwa wamehudhuria. Wao wawili wametoka kwenye dekani ya Mtakatifu Clara eneo la Gatundu, kama tulivyoshuhudia mapema asubuhi ya leo kwenye kanisa la watakatifu mashahidi wa Uganda Gatundu mjini, katika ibada ya misa ya kuagwa.
Lord has made, let us rejoice and be glad, hallelujah.
The disciples whom Jesus loved said, it is the Lord, hallelujah.
Tangu sasa watu wote
yatenda mambo makuu kwa nguvu za mkono wake kwenye kiburi.
Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. Let us praise him and say,
Son of the living God, bless your people.
We pray to you, Lord Jesus, for all ministers of your church, as they break for us the bread of life. May they themselves receive nourishment and strength.
Son of the living God, bless your people.
We pray for the whole Christian people that
that all may be worthy of their calling and safeguard their unity in the Spirit by the bond of peace. O govern us, that they may temper justice with mercy and promote harmony and peace throughout the world. Bishop David, the auxiliary bishop, our two Monsignor Simon Peter and Wallace, that guided by your Holy Spirit they may govern, teach and sanctify the flock of the Archdiocese of Nairobi.
Son of the living God, bless your people.
We pray for ourselves, that our hearts may be purified to sing your praises in the communion of saints. May we be reunited with our deceased brothers and sisters, whom we commend to your loving kindness.
Gathering our prayers and praises into one, let us offer the prayer Christ Himself taught us.
Gave us the Easter mystery as our covenant of reconciliation. May the new birth we celebrate show its effects in the way we live. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Let us remain standing. At this point, the Apostolic Nuncio, who bless the mitres of the Monsignors, skull cap, the staffs and the rings for the bishops elect.
Blessed are you, O God, for making your own Son the eternal high priest of the new covenant, and for choosing our own brothers to be stewards of your mysteries. May your ministers who use these vestments prepared for the celebration of the liturgy and set apart by your blessing, wear them with reverence and honor them with the holiness of their lives. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us be seated. Two announcements. First, I want to thank His Excellency the Nuncio, His Grace, His Lordship, His Eminence. To thank all the priests, deacons, religious men and women. To thank the Holy Family Basilica Administration, led by Father Michael, the CMA, the CWA, the youth, the choir, and the ADN Secretariat, and everybody more so by honoring this great evening. Your coming, your being here for these two Monsignors shows how well we are growing in matters of faith. To everybody, thank you so much. In a very special way, St. Thomas Aquinas Seminary Choir, thank you so much for that wonderful Vespers that you have led us, guided by their liturgist, Father Ikea Patrick. Once again, thank you so much for leading us so solemnly. Announcement number two, tomorrow is the day for the Episcopal ordination of Monsignors Wallace Nganga and Simon Peter Kamamoe. We are requested to arrive early. We are requested to be seated by 8:30 a.m. Kindly, dear Christians, let us arrive on time, 8:30 a.m. All the priests are requested to be seated by 9 a.m. Kindly note, not all priests will join in the procession. Only the deans and the heads of departments, priests, who will be in the procession with the bishops. So kindly, dear priests, let us be seated by 9 a.m. The procession will start at 9:30. We hope the mass, as per the preparations, will start at 10 a.m. Let us commit the two Monsignors to God in prayer as they go through this evening in preparation for tomorrow. At this point, I request His Excellency the Nuncio to give us the blessing to end the Vespers. Kindly, let us all arise.
Bow your heads for God's blessing.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Go forth in peace.
Hallelujah. nimeahidi Yesu kukutumikia, wewe u Bwana wangu urafiki pia, sitaogopa vita, wewe ndiwe mwenza, sitaiacha njia ukiniongoza. Imbeni haleluya, haleluya, imbeni shangwe kwa Bwana Yesu ndiye mwenza wetu. Imbeni haleluya, haleluya, imbeni shangwe kwa Bwana Yesu ndiye mwenza wetu.
Tumsifu Yesu Kristo. Mpendwa mtazamaji wa Capuchin TV, na tunakushukuru kwa kufuatilia matangazo yetu ya hivi leo. Ibada ambayo imekamilika ni sala ya jioni ya watawa na waumini wote kutoka kanisa kuu Holy Family Basilica, jimbo kuu katoliki la Nairobi, ikiwa ni maadhimisho ya maandalizi ya kuwekwa wakfu maaskofu wateule Simon Peter Kamomoe na Wallace Ng'ang'agashihi. Hiyo siku ya kesho, kama ilivyotangazwa, ndio siku ya kuwekwa wakfu tarehe 6 ya mwezi wa 4 kwenye uwanja wa shule ya St. Mary's eneo la Msongari. Ni ibada ambazo tumekuwa nazo kutoka asubuhi, ibada ya misa kutoka dekania ya Mtakatifu Clara Gatundu, na imemalizika na ibada hii ya sala ya jioni. Kwa niaba yangu mimi ningependa kuwashukuru na kuwapongeza wale wote waliofanikisha matangazo haya siku hii ya leo, vijana waliokimbia na kuketi na kusimama masaa marefu ili ibada hizi zikufikie kutoka maeneo yote ambayo tumekuwa tukifanya kazi, dereva wetu Justus, wapiga picha wetu Charles Mavaton, Anthony Molama na Joel Mbogwa, aliyekuwa akichanganya picha Samebor Cheruyot, pamoja na aliyekuwa anachanganya sauti Eric Otieno. Mimi ndugu Francisco Mkapuchini Peter Wabairo, tukikudusha studio kwa injinia Peter Mwangi kwa matangazo yanayosalia. Tukutane hapo kesho kwenye uwanja wa St. Mary's kama ilivyotangazwa mapema asubuhi, siku aliyoifanya Bwana. Ikawa jioni, ikawa asubuhi, siku ya kwanza katika siku tatu maalum kwa hawa wateule. Jioni njema. Tumsifu Yesu Kristo.
Capuchin actually is contributing so effectively to the evangelization in the Kenyan church. Remember, on Good Friday we were together the whole journey. Remember, the whole journey of the way of the cross, they were together, they were covering, and even on Holy Thursday they were still with us. Let us support it because we need it. The media people, other media people, are so secular. They cover mostly the secular informations. But the Capuchin TV will cover the religious, you know, messages, the gospel, the teachings of the church. So for me, I would encourage each one of you, let us give them moral support, material support, and encouragement so that they will continue to contribute in the evangelization, in the church, in the Kenyan church, not even the Kenyan church. Many people who are outside the country, even in America and Europe, they watch Capuchin TV, even through the YouTube and Facebook, they watch, and so they are doing a wonderful job. Capuchin TV, hongera sana.
Tumetoka mbali, bado tuko mbali, na tunaenda wapi? Mbali.
Endelea kutazama Capuchin TV, huduma katoliki ya uinjilishaji.
Ni upendo kwa tundani habani.
mpendwa muumini, tumsifu Yesu Kristu. Baada ya Baba Mtakatifu Francisco kuwateua makuhani wawili kuwa maaskofu wasaidizi kwenye jimbo kuu la Nairobi, yanakaribia maadhimisho ya kuagwa, kupokelewa, kuwekwa wakfu na shukrani zao.
Ijumaa, tarehe 5 Aprili, itafanyika ibada ya misa ya kuaga Monsinyori Simon Peter Kamomoe na Monsinyori Wallace Ng'ang'a kutoka nyumbani kwao, dekania ya Mtakatifu Clara Gatundu.
Ibada hiyo itafanyika kwenye parokia ya Watakatifu Mashahidi wa Uganda mjini Gatundu, ikiongozwa na Askofu David Kamau kuanzia saa 4 asubuhi.
Baada ya misa, wateule hao wakisindikizwa na mapadre na waumini wataelekea kwenye kanisa la parokia ya Watakatifu Petro na Paulo mjini Kiambu.
Wanatarajiwa kufika hapo mwendo wa saa 8 mchana na kuwasalimia waumini.
Baadaye, mwendo wa saa 10 alasiri, wateule hao watawasili kwenye kanisa kuu la Holy Family Basilica mjini Nairobi, ambapo watapokelewa na mhashamu askofu mkuu Philip Anyolo, mapadre, watawa, pamoja na waumini wengine.
Saa 11 jioni itafanyika ibada ya sala ya jioni kwenye kanisa lilo hilo, ambapo maaskofu wateule wataahidi uaminifu katika huduma ya waskofu pamoja na kukiri imani.
Ikue jioni, ikue asubuhi, siku ya kwanza.
Nayo siku ya pili, Jumamosi tarehe 6, itakuwa siku ya kihistoria ya kuwekwa wakfu maaskofu wateule Monsinyori Simon Peter Kamomoe na Monsinyori Wallace Ng'ang'a.
Ibada ya misa itafanyika kwenye uwanja wa shule ya St. Mary's eneo la Msongari kuanzia saa 4 asubuhi.
Msimikaji mkuu na kiongozi wa ibada atakuwa mwakilishi wa Baba Mtakatifu hapa nchini, mhashamu Bart Van Meegen.
Kwaya itakayoongoza itatoka kwenye dekania ya Mtakatifu Clara Gatundu. Waumini wanaombwa kufika mapema na kuwa wameketi ifikapo saa 3 asubuhi.
Rangi ya liturujia itakuwa nyeupe ama dhahabu, na mapadri wote wanakumbushwa kuvaa kasula ama chasubo.
Baada ya ibada, maaskofu hao wawili watajiandaa kwa shukrani siku itakayofuata.
Ikue jioni, ikue asubuhi, siku ya pili.
Siku ya tatu, Jumapili ya pili ya Pasaka, ama Jumapili ya huruma ya Mungu, Divine Mercy Sunday, itakuwa tarehe 7 Aprili. Siku hii itakuwa siku za shukrani za wahashamu hao wawili.
Mhashamu Simon Peter Kamomoe ataongoza ibada kwenye kanisa kuu la Holy Family Basilica, Nairobi mjini, misa ya saa 2 asubuhi na saa 5 asubuhi.
Mhashamu Wallace Ng'ang'a naye atakuwa nyumbani pamoja na waumini wa parokia ya Yesu Kristo Mfalme eneo la Karinga.
Ibada ya misa itaanza saa 3 na nusu asubuhi. Ikue jioni, ikue asubuhi, siku ya tatu. Matukio na ibada za siku hizo tatu zitakujia kikamilifu na taadhima zote hapa tu Kapuchin TV, maneno na matendo,
masomo na maombi,
mavazi na mapambo,
maelezo na maelekezo. Kwa kuwa Kapuchin TV ndicho kituo cha kipekee kinachoweza kukuletea hayo bila kupunguza ama kuongeza chumvi.
Mungu abariki Jimbo Kuu Katoliki la Nairobi pamoja na maaskofu wake, mapadri, watawa na waumini wote.
Endelea kutazama Kapuchin TV,
kitambulisho chako Katoliki.
Ni kwenye vitongoji duni vya kwetu ambapo pana ukombozi. Nani mkombozi? Nani anayekombolewa? Na, ni ukombozi upi? Kitongoji cha kwetu ni mojawapo wa vitongoji vya Mombasa. Kitovu chake ni Padre Michael. Padre Mkatoliki ambaye amejizatiti na kung'oa nanga safari mahususi ya kukabiliana na dawa za kulevya, uhalifu na uozo wa tabia kwenye jamii yake.
Siwezi kuendelea hivyo. Nimechoka na maisha tunayoishi na nahitaji kujitoa. Siwezi endelea kufanya hivyo.
Hauwezi tu kujitoa. Kumbuka tuliapa. Maisha haya ndio tunayo.
Kwenye parokia yake mpya ya kwetu.
Mimi ndio Father Mgeni hapa.
Father Michael. Father Mgeni.
Padre Michael ana nia kuu ya kuinua vijana wanaohangaika na kuwapa tumaini kwenye maisha yao.
Tuko na kazi kubwa usiku wa leo. Ushindi mkubwa humo ndani.
Kwenye kukabiliana na changamoto chungu nzima za vitongojini, Padre Michael anakutana ana kwa ana na vijana wengi ambao wamenaswa na mtego wa utumiaji wa dawa za kulevya na uhalifu. Vijana hao ambao hapo mbeleni walikuwa vielelezo na haswa kanisani, kwa sasa wamejipata kwenye dimbwi la ukiwa na mahangaiko na kukata tamaa.
Hivi lakini wewe unahusika na nini?
Nisikie kwa makini Sara. Sina wakati wa kuhusishwa na madai yasiyokuwa ya msingi.
Kwenye simulizi la ukombozi, tunangamua wazi mahangaiko na simulizi ya vijana hawa. Kuanzia kwa Sara, mwana harakati ambaye amejitolea kuwasaidia wanarika wenzake, hadi kwa Kelvin, mhalifu aliyebadilisha mwendo na anayetafuta ukombozi. Simulizi hii inapigia mbizi hisia za safari ndefu ya mabadiliko na kufanywa upya. Hata kukiwa na pingamizi ndani na nje ya vitongoji hivi, Padre Michael anaendelea na nia yake isiyotingika, ikipigwa jeki pakubwa na kanisa na wanaojitolea. Kwa pamoja, wanasimama kama mwanga wa tumaini, wakiwa na nia kupanda mbegu ya mabadiliko na ukombozi.
Padre Michael, tuna matumaini makuu ya kukuza jamii iliyo njema. Lakini pamoja na hayo, hatuwezi kusahau changamoto tunazopitia kama kanisa.
Safari kamwe sio rahisi rafiki yangu. Tutangangana hivyo. Hapa katikati ya mapambano ndipo ninapoanza.
Ungana nasi hapa Capuchin TV kila Jumamosi saa 1 jioni na Jumapili saa 9:30. Ukombozi.
The Lord is my strength and my shield. In Him my heart rejoices. Psalms chapter 28 verse 7. On Monday, the 15th of April 2024, the Capuchin TV antenna will transmit signals from Kebugoye village in Kisii to mark the Silver Jubilee celebrations of Sister Mary Lucy Marcy of the Congregation of the Sisters of the Blessed Virgin Mary, SBV. The Eucharistic celebration will commence at 10 a.m. East African time at the Nyansiongo Parish in Kisii Diocese, led by the Right Reverend Joseph Mairura Okemwa, the Shepherd of Kisii Bishopric. You are all invited to join us in celebrating the gift of religious life physically in Kebugoye Village or virtually on Capuchin Television or its corresponding YouTube and Facebook platforms. Capuchin TV extends warm congratulations to you, Sister Mary Lucy, for your dedicated service in the Lord's Vineyard for the past 25 years. Happy anniversary to you. Keep watching Capuchin TV, your Catholic identity.
My name is David Mukaru, CEO Caritas Microfinance Bank. We have a message from the board, management and staff of Caritas Microfinance Bank. We wish to congratulate Right Reverend Simon Peter Kamomoe and Right Reverend Wallace Nganga on your episcopate appointment and ordination as auxiliary bishops of the Metropolitan Archdiocese of Nairobi. This is a momentous occasion, not only for you, but also to the entire metropolitan community you will serve. Your dedication, wisdom, and faith have brought you to this esteemed position, and we have no doubt that you lead with grace and compassion. As you embark on your episcopal journey, may you find strength in your faith, wisdom in your decisions, and courage in your challenges. Your leadership will undoubtedly inspire others and guide them towards spiritual growth and fulfillment. Caritas Microfinance Bank family sends its heartfelt support and prayers as you undertake this sacred responsibility. May God bless you abundantly as you shepherd this flock with love and humility. Pamoja tuimarisha jamii.
I will praise you with all my heart, O Lord my God. I will proclaim your greatness forever. Psalms 86 verse 12. With joyful hearts and gratitude to the Lord, the parish priest of Tabaka Parish, along with the Christians and the family of the late John Onchiku Marima and Robina Jabondo Onchiku, cordially invite you to the Silver Jubilee Thanksgiving Mass of their daughter, Sister Mary Esther Oyuma Onchiku of the Sisters of the Blessed Virgin. This momentous occasion will take place on Saturday the 13th of April this year at her home, St. Mary's Nyabigena Girls Secondary and Primary Schools. The Holy Mass will commence at 10 a.m. and will be brought to you live on Capuchin TV and across its various social media platforms. This momentous occasion will be graced by Bishop Joseph Mairura of the Catholic Diocese of Kisii. Capuchin TV extends heartfelt congratulations to Sister Mary Esther as she marks her silver jubilee, wishing her God's abundant blessings, strength and good health as she continues her service in the Lord's vineyard. Keep watching Capuchin TV, your Catholic identity channel.
Welcome to Tangaza University College, a multicultural community of holistic formation rooted in gospel values. Our academic programs include postgraduate, undergraduate degrees, diplomas, and certificate courses. At Tangaza University College, we pride ourselves as the leading college in inclusivity, with all our learning facilities attuned to accommodate students with special needs. Delight in an ambient environment, professional lecturers, and world-class learning facilities, including a spacious, well-equipped library, a research center, science laboratories, and a multimedia studio. Our full-time and part-time intakes are open in January, May, and August every year. We also offer holiday-based programs in April, August, and December. For more information about our courses and enrollment procedure, visit us along Langata South Road in Karen, Nairobi, or visit our website at www.tangaza.ac.ke. For remote inquiries, send an email to inquiries@tangaza.ac.ke or call us on 0722-204-724. Or 0733-685-059. Enroll now for our competitive PhD, Masters, Bachelors, Diplomas, and Certificate courses. Tangaza University College, teaching minds, touching hearts, and transforming lives.
Microfinance Bank imejitolea muhanga kwa kuwawezesha wa Kenya kupata fedha kwa urahisi ili kujenga rasilimali na kujiendeleza. Maisha ya jamii yamebadilika na kuimarika. Msingi wa jamii ni utulivu wa familia iliyoimarika. Ukiwa na mradi unayohitaji kuimarishwa, tuna utu. Karibu zungumze nasi. Caritas Microfinance Bank.
Imarika, imarika.
Seeking expert medical care that prioritizes both your health and well-being? Welcome to St. Mary's Mission Hospital, Langata, where compassionate care meets cutting-edge medicine. At St. Mary's, we believe in providing holistic health care, Our dedicated team of healthcare professionals is committed to delivering personalized care to each and every patient. Nestled in the heart of Langata, our hospital offers a peaceful and healing environment for patients to recover and thrive.
We have masses every day, weekdays at 6:30 a.m. in the morning, and also in the evening at 6:30 p.m.
Your health is our top priority. Experience the difference with compassion and trust. Whether you're in need of routine medical care, specialized treatment, or emergency services, St. Mary's Mission Hospital Langata is here for you. We offer a comprehensive range of services including outpatient, inpatient services, laboratory services, comprehensive care clinic, MCH and maternity.
We have labor and delivery. We also have postnatal care. And also we deal with mothers who've come that are sick and are in the antenatal period. That is antenatal care. Generally, we admit every mother who walks in labor and any mother who comes from the clinic for monitoring of labor and also delivery services. And also in maternity, we have a theater whereby all mothers who are not delivering normal are usually taken to theater for cesarean section.
Ophthalmology, pharmacy services, radiology and sonography, dental services, pediatrics, physiotherapy, ICU and HDU services, dialysis.
Here we do dialysis for kidney failed patients and we do it from Monday through Saturday. We welcome you all. We accept all insurances and cash.
Specialist clinics and CT scan services. Experience your health difference with us. Visit us at Langata or our branches in Nairobi at Cardinal Tunga Plaza and in Rift Valley Elementaita, Nakuru County. For more information, contact us at 0797-972-794. Or 0769-781-880 or 0717-305-204 or email us at info@stmarysmissionhospital.co.ke. St. Mary's Mission Hospital Langata, compassionate in healthcare. Are you tired of dead-end jobs? Feeling stuck without a career path? It is time to take control of your future. St. Kizito Vocational Training Institute, your one-stop destination for technical courses since 1994, has got a solution for you.
And the aim of the school was to take care of the young people from the marginalized areas of Nairobi. Who had finished school or they had dropped out of school and they did not have, their parents didn't have maybe money to take them to university and other colleges. A number of them also were out of school, drop out of school because of effects of drugs. So to help them not to engage in other form of things that are not useful to their life, like maybe criminality and all these things.
Owned by the Catholic Archdiocese of Nairobi, we have bagged 30 years of empowering unemployed youth from marginalized communities, churning out thousands job creators to the market.
We have a number of courses: electrical, electronics, motor vehicle mechanics, plumbing and metalwork, carpentry and cabinet making, catering, hair and beauty, and computer. We also offer short courses, defensive driving, programmable logical controls, that is automations, and solar.
Reap maximum benefits from our spacious departments, fully fledged with state-of-the-art tools for practical learning.
Our school has been involved mostly in what we call the dual training. Dual training is what people are calling the cabinet-based education. We started this way back in 1994. So we have been following this model of dual training, where students study in school and they go to the industry. So it's like they alternate industry and school. So this is what has made our school to excel, because most of the students who are following this model, especially the ladies, they have really succeeded very well. Maybe within 6 months, someone is able to finish the course and start working. So we are encouraging more young people to join our courses.
Whether you dropped out of school at any level or looking to upgrade your skills, St. Kizitol Vocational Training Institute has got a course for you.
Our requirements, we accept students from all levels of education. Those who have finished class 8, they have a place in our school. Those who have dropped high school, they have a place in our school. And those who have finished high school and they want to pursue their careers in technical courses, we have a place for them.
You know, he's from Sudan, mm-hmm. and from Southern Sudan, and I think he has not reached the level of the Kenya education, but he's here studying, you know. And that's what we were saying. We have also this program of the dual training, where students study in school and they go to the industry. So when you go to the industry, you are more exposed and you discover your potential. So the school is very open. It's very open for anybody who wants to study. We accommodate them.
From automotive engineering to culinary arts and other technical courses, there is something for everyone at St. Kizitol VTI.
The reason why I chose carpentry is because there's not a lot of people who do carpentry, especially for the guys. Mm-hmm. And it actually has a huge market. Mm-hmm. Yes, because first I was inspired to carpentry through interior design.
Italian design, the company.
Interior design. It is also related to carpentry. It's almost the same field. So I decided to just do it wholly, mm-hmm. because that is also a ground.
And the best part, low fees for quality training. It is never too late to pursue your dreams.
Since you want to demonstrate, Onesha. We do exams, NITA exams, and as you know, NITA, anybody can book exams and do the NITA exams. And also we have the NEC, Kenya National Examination Council exams. So those who have finished high school and maybe they want to start a journey in technical education, they have a place in our school.
Give yourself the chance to rebuild your career path with ease. Enroll in a course of your choice today. Visit our headquarters nestled along Mihoko Road in Githurai, Kimbo, Nairobi County.
So we have two branches. The main branch is here in Githurai, Kimbo. And we have a branch in Roysambu, TRM Drive, behind Jewel Complex.
For inquiries, call our main campus on 0724-238-716 or our Roysambu branch on 0724-253-547 or email info@stkizito.ac.ke. You can also visit our website at www.stkizito.com.
So we welcome all of you to St. Kizito. I promise you that many have passed through this education and they are working, they are enjoying, and they don't regret.
St. Kizito Vocational Training Institute, where you discover how to love work. Our Lord Jesus Christ became one of us to save us and to show us how to live as God's children. He called and sent out disciples to evangelize everyone, everywhere in the world. Mark chapter 16, verse 15. In a world hungering for basic needs, hope, justice, and peace, with some celebrating Mass under trees, there exists a beam of light. St. Patrick's Missionary Society. As baptized Christians, we are all stakeholders in this divine mission. Today, we extend a kind invitation to all Christians to wake up to the missionary mandate and collaborate with us to promote the mission of Christ through the Church. At the forefront of this noble cause are the St. Patrick's Missionary Priests, commonly known as Kiltigan Fathers. They are tirelessly championing the missionary mandate in the neediest of places where the Catholic faith is weak or yet to be germinated, serving in parts of Mombasa, Nairobi, Nakuru, Eldoret, Kitale, Turkana, and some parts of South Sudan. St. Patrick's missionaries have been transforming lives since 1950. From feeding the hungry to sponsoring education, drilling boreholes for clean water to building churches, nurturing both spiritual and humanitarian needs. We offer masses daily for the intentions of our benefactors. Together with your support, we evangelize the world. Christ's love compels us, and with your help, we can spread that love to the farthest boundaries. To continue this sacred work, we need your support. We are reaching out to you, our brothers and sisters in faith, for your financial and spiritual assistance. May God bless you abundantly for your support and partnership. Thank you for joining us in this transformative journey.